This question is just to do with fear, and I know a lot of us in our sort of daily life, for example, with me, when I have exams, when I have a job interview, I would feel fear. And I was just wondering, first of all, sort of where does it come from, why is it there, and what are the solutions to it? If I had something that that was on my mind, I would sort of think about it all the time. And I believe Buddha said the best thing is to actually think in the present all the time. I was wondering, is the best thing to overcome it, is it to fight it head on? And actually, is that God trying to manifest through us and trying to express himself?
All these issues like fear, aversion, attraction, all the human emotions we feel, in a way reveal, if you like, our inner dimension. Unknowingly, indirectly, they are revealing our inner dimension. What is the inner dimension? Our inner dimension is pure, pristine spirit. That is our inner dimension. When this particular thing that is our essential nature is manifesting or making its appearance through a particular frame, look, this frame through which it's looking out, the same spirit looking out through here, looking out through those eyes. When it does this, it pays a price. This is the reason why we have all these things: aversion, attraction, fear. You know, Gujaratima, Gruna, Lajja, Bhaya, these are standard things for every living thing, not only human being, every living thing. We have these things kind of inbuilt in us. So what is it all about? Let's explore fear. What is the origin of fear? And then we look at the different dimensions to fear. It's a very interesting thing to explore. Now, you see, right from we Hindus have always said that we have come out of the animal kingdom. You see, if you look at the Dash Avatar of the Hindus, the narrative of the Hindus, we'll talk about the fish idea, the idea of animal, the idea of kind of evolving into a wild human. Parshuram was a wild, and then ideal human, Ram. So we have always recognized the importance of evolution. We recognize we came out of the animal kingdom. Now this is where the story begins. It begins a long time before we reach the human stage. When we were in the animal kingdom, the only way we could survive is if we heard a roar of the lion and we are a little gazelle eating grass, chewing grass. We run. Fear grips us and we run like hell. It is purely a survival mechanism. If you didn't have fear, if the gazelle doesn't have fear and he keeps chewing grass, he goes on very fast. He is used for lunch very fast. So he used to run. So the fear is something that we have acquired from the animal kingdom. So it didn't start in the human kingdom. In the human kingdom, the fear is now with whether my boss will be happy with my performance. So he's not worried about somebody jumping on you and eating you up. But the fear that the inherent fear, we all have it. Remember, we all have it. We acquired it from the animal kingdom. So if you suddenly hear a clap of thunder, we all go like that. You see, it comes from the animal level. It has become instinct for us. It has become part and parcel of our character. And it comes right from the animal kingdom into the human kingdom. Now, the Hindus have explored this idea well and say, in fact, they say, if you can become fearless, then you are spiritual. Forget about all other things, bhakti and all this. Forget all that. Suppose you can overcome fear. Just one particular element that is visible in your life. You can overcome fear. You hit the jackpot. Just becoming fearless. This is why it's called Abhaya. In fact, the whole message of the Upanishads is to offer this Abhayapada, this fearlessness to whole of humanity. He said the only way you can rise above the fear, and every level of fear, it can be very physical fear, you know, can you hear a bang or a shot, something fire, and you kind of shudder or whatever. Or in the human kingdom, the fear kind of becomes a little bit more kind of unusual in the sense that it has got social dimension to it. You know, your work ethics and your place of work will, in a way, produce certain pressure. It's still survival. Remember, it's still survival mechanism. So in the office, the reason why you fear your boss is because you may lose your job, and you must have your job and have your money and your food. It's still a survival mechanism, but more sophisticated. But it's still the same survival mechanism becoming visible in the human kingdom. So fear is inherent in us, and achieving fearlessness is the aim of the Upanishads. This is the thundering material that the Hindus are producing. Do you want to just rise above fear? Then study this thing we call the Upanishads. So what does the Upanishads do? That's what we're just saying in the Prarthana. See this universe, when you see it in its true color, it is not what it appears to be. And the moment you see the deeper aspect to this reality, you rise above this very limited idea that I am this body that needs to survive. All these ideas are left behind. You rise above fear. And this Abhaya Pada is the central message of the Upanishads. So what Rajiv is asking is very crucial. This is why the Upanishads were produced, to make us raise ourselves above fear. And this is central and doesn't go away. In a way, what I can say is it is one of the things that become visible when the spirit wants to express itself through the body and mind. It pays a price. And one of the cost is acquiring fear. That was, if you like, the survival mechanism that you possess that will continue to kick in and continue to prod you, continue to make you aware that there is danger or your survival is threatened. That is why it arises in the first place.